Welcome back. In this video, we are going to complete the puzzle, the missing piece in the puzzle. We already know how to create a smart contract, and we have already deployed a few smart contracts to the blockchain. And now to complete the picture, we need to know how to send this smart contract to another user. I want to be able to send my smart contract to another user so that user might interact with it. And in order for the user to be able to watch my contract, I need to provide him with two things. First of all, I need to give him the address of the contract. Where is this contract stored on the blockchain? And the second thing that I need to give him is the application interface, or ABI, Application Binary Interface, ABI. To see the interface of a certain contract, that's quite simple. We just go to our contract. We just choose one of those contracts which we have deployed in the past. Let's say a Bitcoin course. This is a Bitcoin course September. We've already deployed this contract in the past. We have this address of the course, and I can send this address to anyone, so he might see this contract. But he won't be able to interact with this contract unless I will send him the interface as well. And the interface can be found by pressing over here, show interface. This is the interface of this Bitcoin course, and this information is needed in order for the other party, for the other user, to be able to interact with this Bitcoin course September contract. Pay attention that the interface is being provided as a JSON file. If you are not familiar with the concept of JSON, JSON is a way to display strings and objects in JavaScript, and it is very useful to have an information displayed in this way because it also allows you to be able to interact with this information from third-party applications as well. Currently, there aren't so many third-party applications for Ethereum. There is the Mist Wallet, the Mist Browser, and a few other third-party applications, but the ecosystem is still in its infantry stage, and we can expect that many more browsers and wallets will be deployed in the next month or even weeks, and that those third-party applications will find it much easier to interact with the Ethereum protocol, with the Ethereum blockchain, thanks to this JSON format. So now, after I've sent the person with the address and the interface, this person can then decide to watch the contract. And I'm going to show you an example of how to do it in the Mist wallet. And for this example, I've chosen over here the DAO. You remember that in the previous lesson, we've talked about the DAO, the Decentralized Autonomous Organization. Well, we saw the source code of this Decentralized Autonomous Organization. But now I also want to show you how you can interact with this DAO. And the way to do so will be to first find the address of the DAO, and this is the address of the DAO. And second, you will need to find the ABI, the Application Binary Interface, over here. This is the ABI, all of this, the ABI of the DAO. It's quite long, but we're just going to copy and paste it, no more than that. And the DAO, it's a contract which has been deployed to the main Ethereum network. This is already in work in progress. So, in my Mist wallet, I'm going to leave the testnet. And now I'm going to go to the mainnet. This is the actual net. This is the actual network. Once on this network, I need to be very careful so I won't lose any Ether. There we go. Right now, this is the main network. This is my real private account. And in order to see this DAO contract, I need to go to contracts. I need to go down here to watch contract. Now I need to insert the name of the contract. I can insert whichever name I want. I can just say, I want to watch it. It doesn't really matter. This is just the name that it's going to be displayed on my screen. It's not the real name of the contract. I need to insert the address of the contract. So we're going to take this address over here from the top. This is the address of the contract. Now I'm just going to paste the address. And I need to insert the JSON interface. The JSON interface or the ABI. So let's go back here. There we go. This is the ABI. I just need to copy it. And JSON interface. There we go. And there we go. Now this contract was added to my contract list. I can press this contract. And I can see that I can interact with it. I can read from the contract. I can look at all the variables, the public variables that this contract contain. I can select a function to interact with this contract. I can call a function, approve, transfer without reward, receive ether, etc. And everything is, of course, depends on the logics of the contract. Not all of those functions I will actually be allowed to use, but at least I'm allowed to see how they work, and I might try to execute them. And if I am properly authorized and fulfill all the conditions in order to execute one of those functions, I will be able to send this function and to interact with this contract. So this was it about how you're going to watch a smart contract, how you can send a smart contract which you've created to another user, and now you can also watch and interact with another contract which was already deployed either to the main network, to the main blockchain, or even just to the test blockchain. So I hope that so far you find this information useful. And again, this is the main testnet, so I wouldn't really suggest to play with it so much. But feel free to create as many contracts as you want on the testnet and to send them to your friend and ask them to send you contracts and just start play with them and start to see how you can interact with those contracts as well. Nothing is better than practice. So keep on practice and good luck, and I will see you later.